JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for September the 11th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against most of the other G10 currencies on Thursday and during the Asian morning Friday. It recorded the most gains against the British pound, and then against NOK and the Kiwi, while it underperformed slightly against the Swiss franc and the euro. The greenback was found virtually unchanged versus the Aussie. The strengthening of the US dollar and the Swiss franc suggests that the financial community traded in a risk-off fashion once again. Indeed, most major EU indices closed their Thursday session in the red, with the only exception being Italy's FTSE MIB, which gained 0.25%. Risk aversion intensified during the US session, with Wall Street's main indices losing on average 1.73%. The main loser was Nasdaq, as investors may have decided to lock profits on tech stocks again. Firms that rallied since March lows, such as Apple Inc., Microsoft Corp., and Amazon.com, fell at least 2.8%. That said, sentiment improved during the Asian session today. Although South Korea's KOSPI is trading virtually unchanged, Japan's Nikkei 225 and China's Shanghai Composite are up 0.61 and 0.36% respectively. Yesterday, the main event on the financial agenda was the ECB monetary policy decision. The bank kept its monetary policy unchanged, reiterating that they stand ready to adjust all their instruments as appropriate to ensure that inflation moves towards its aim in a sustained manner. Although President Lagarde said that the risks of the economic outlook remain to the downside, the bank's GDP projections were revised slightly higher. Inflation forecasts were unchanged for this year, slightly upgraded for 2021, and unchanged again for 2022. Now, in the Q&A session, when asked about the euro's latest strength, President Lagarde noted that the extent to which the euro affects prices negatively was discussed extensively and that it must be monitored carefully. However, she highlighted that the bank does not target the exchange rate. Now, following comments by ECB chief economist Philip Lane that the euro-dollar exchange rate does matter for monetary policy, many investors may have been waiting a more dovish language, and this is evident by the rally in the euro after Lagarde said that the ECB is not targeting the exchange rate. However, the rally in euro-dollar did not last for long. The broader risk aversion boosted the safe haven dollar, with the pair reiterating back near to its pre-ECB levels. Now, staying in the FX sphere, the British pound was by far the main loser among the G10 currencies, and this may have been due to increasing fears over a no-deal Brexit. Yesterday, the EU told Britain that it should urgently scrap plans to amend the withdrawal agreement, but the UK government refused to do so and instead pressed ahead with a draft law that will override key parts of the accord. As we noted on Tuesday, all these tensions lessen even further the chances of any progress being made for reaching common ground before the October deadline, something that increases the chances for a no-deal Brexit at the end of the year when the transition period expires. In our view, this is likely to keep the pound under selling interest for a while more. Now, as for today's events, during the European morning, we already got the UK monthly GDP for July alongside the industrial and manufacturing production rates for the same month. The data showed that economic activity slowed to 6.6% month over month from 8.7% in June, while both the industrial and manufacturing production year over year rates, although they stayed within the negative territory, increased by more than expected. The pound barely reacted to the releases, as its traders may have kept their gaze locked on the political scene and especially developments surrounding Brexit. Now, later in the day, we get the US CPIs for August. The headline rate is anticipated to have increased to 1.2% year over year from 1%, while the core one is expected to have held steady at 1.6% year over year. A couple of weeks ago, speaking at the Jackson Hole Economic Symposium, Fed Chief Powell said that the Fed will now target a 2% average inflation and put emphasis on broad and inclusive employment, with the shift motivated by underlying changes to the economy, including lower potential growth, persistently lower interest rates, and low inflation. Although he added that the committee is not tying itself to any particular method to define average inflation, this means that the Fed is willing to tolerate above 2% inflation for a while before raising interest rates, which implies extra loose monetary policy for longer. What's more, in the minutes of the latest FOMC gathering, it was revealed that additional accommodation may be required. Thus, taking all this into account, we doubt that a small acceleration in inflation will alter policymakers' plans with regards to monetary policy. We also have two speakers on today's agenda, and those are ECB Governing Council members Isabel Schnabel and Jens Weidmann. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.